Welcome back to Play and Trade Guitars. I'm John, that's Zach behind the camera, and this is Play and Trade Guitars, where we play it and trade it. And we're checking out a limited edition Stratocaster today. And I think it's gonna have some lovers and possibly some haters. I am a lover. This is the limited edition Fender American Professional II thin line Stratocaster. Yes, you heard right. Maybe this is the way Leo Fender originally envisioned the Stratocaster. We're talking a semi-hollow Stratocaster chambered with an F-hole. It's wild, but it looks awesome. It's got a beautiful rosewood fretboard. I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know when we put it on the bench and pull it apart. Of course, we're gonna plug it in and play it. At the top, if you are in the market for something new like this, the Thinline Strat looks pretty awesome if you ask me. Click to buy that new gear using our link. You'll find that pinned in the comments or down in the description. When you buy new gear using our link, you help us make these demos, so thanks for doing that. Also, be in it to win it. Do us a favor, if you haven't, hit subscribe now and sign up via Gleam, because we are giving away an American-made Martin acoustic guitar when we hit 100,000 subscribers. To win that guitar, sign up via Gleam and make sure you're subscribed. One of you is gonna be the lucky winner of that amazing Martin acoustic guitar. Without further ado, let's take a first look at the Thinline Stratocaster. This thing is wild. I think it's awesome. Drop a comment as we go and let me know what you think of the new limited edition Thinline Strat. Let's get to work. All right, it includes that great TSA molded hard shell case. Check this out, shell pink. Look at this, F-hole on a Stratocaster, semi-hollow guitar, chambered. Pretty incredible. Another cool feature, ash body. I thought for a while they said Fender was gonna be done with ash. So in regular production, American Professional II with the ash body. Rosewood fretboard, this one is particularly beautiful. And you got this kind of semi-gloss finish. I love when they do this kind of aged coloring of the maple itself. Nice slab of rosewood, contoured heel. Price on this is $19.49 with the hard shell case. This is probably my favorite color, but there are some great choices. You can find all those using our link pinned in the comments or down in the description. And you can check out current availability there. But I am kind of in love with this. I also love the tortoise shell pickguard. I think it looks fantastic against the pink. You can really see a lot of the ash grain popping through that kind of transparent pink finish. And there's just something so striking. So of course we're gonna see what it sounds like. I can tell you, it feels great in the hands already. Why don't we head over to the bench and pull it apart before we plug it in? Drop a comment, what do you think? I can get behind this. I dig this. Let me know in the comments. Let's hit the bench. Check this out. If you really want to go crazy and get yourself an ES Les Paul and have a real different collection. All right, I'm excited about this one. So starting at the top of the headstock, Fender Spaghetti logo. Flipping it over, you got the stamped Fender tuners. And Fender is celebrating this year's 70th anniversary of the Stratocaster, going all the way back to 1954. This guitar is made in Corona, California, so you got the American Professional II series. I love this semi-gloss. You can kind of see already. It's not quite full gloss. Comfortable sort of semi-satin feel in the hand. And also for reaching that upper register, as if it wasn't already easy enough on a Stratocaster, you now have the contoured heel. And that's a nice touch too. Love that it's an ash body. I really did think that was out of production, but here it is. Striking tortoise shell pickguard against that ash grain in this white pink, pearl pink finish. And then look at this, you can see the raw ash with the chambering of the body itself. It's still all the same Strat contours. It's just gonna be semi-hollow. It is routed out. And probably not the easiest thing to make in production. I think that's a pretty cool idea. Beautiful piece of rosewood on this fretboard. Quality control is looking good. I don't see any issues. And why don't we get the strings out of the way and get some measurements. This limited edition model sports a bone nut, and that comes in at 1.68 inches wide. We got a first fret at 0.81 inches, up to a 12th of 0.89 inches. Ash body comes in at 1.78 inches thick. We got the V-Mod 2 pickups here, single coils. And one really cool feature is you got a push-push tone that actually adds the neck pickup. So if you want to go bridge and neck, that kind of Gilmore sound, or if you want all on in position two, you just use that push-push to add the neck in that configuration. Check that out. Body is already routed for humbucker in neck position if you want to get crazy, and bridge position. So if you want to add humbuckers in any of those positions, it's already routed to do that. Otherwise, you got these hand-wired controls and those V-Mod 2 pickups. All right, let's flip on the multimeter and get a reading on those pickups. We're at 6.1 in bridge, 6.0 in middle, and 5.9 in neck, standard five-way Strat. You got the modern two-point trim, but I like these Fender embossed saddles here. Those look sharp. Flipping it around, I'll give you a look at the trim block. And a nice setup on the trim, just a little bit of a float from the factory, so nothing to do there. All right, we'll see if semi-hollow strat means a lighter strat. Plus that ash body tends to be a little bit lighter. Nope, 8 pounds, 5 ounces, we'll call it 8.4 pounds. Not a bad weight, but a little bit on the heavier side for a strat. And then flipping the guitar around for an initial reaction. Good float on the trem. I'm really excited to plug it in and just hear that semi-hollow sound coming from a Stratocaster guitar. It feels great from the factory. I'm a fan of the satin neck that they do on this series, so it's not super high gloss. It's kind of a semi-satin finish. Nice finish on this guitar, good size frets even. Very comfortable. Good setup from the factory. We're gonna plug it in a second. Remember, if you're in the market for this guitar or any other gear, click to buy that gear using our link. It helps us make these demos, so thanks for doing that as always. This really is my favorite part. We're gonna plug it in, show you clean tones, we'll dirty it up, and then we'll let it sing behind a track. On the other side of that, I'll give you my raw, honest reaction to playing this guitar along with a final score. So stay tuned, drop a comment as we go, and let's get plugged in.
Thank you.
All right, you stuck with me to the end, so I'll tell you what I think, but what do you think? Drop a comment, let me know what you think of this semi-hollow, just amazing to look at, a chambered Stratocaster, the thin line Stratocaster. I'm gonna give you my final score based on three main categories: overall playability, overall sound, overall value. When it comes to playability, standout features in terms of construction, no issues. Everything was put together really, really well. I like that satin feel, kind of semi-satin feel on the neck. I always love rosewood, and a beautiful piece of rosewood on this guitar for sure. Trem came set up perfectly, just the right amount of float from the factory. And I'll tell you what, in terms of overall playability, I'm gonna give this one a high score of 9.3 on overall playability. Overall sound, these V-Mod pickups, I'm gonna have to listen back. They didn't immediately grab my heart when I heard them, and I can't tell how much of that is the Strat sound I'm expecting to hear versus the addition of now having, of course, let's talk about sound, the chambered body with the F-hole, the fact that this is a semi-hollow Stratocaster. I do feel and hear a difference in tone for sure. To what degree the characteristics of the pickups are actually changing the sound along with the semi-hollow, it's not as prominent sounding as a semi-hollow guitar. So I would tell you to put out of your head that it's gonna really sound like a semi-hollow guitar. It sounds like a tweaked Stratocaster, if that makes sense. There's a little bit more of a hollowness, you know, no pun intended, to the tone. And it's cool, it makes you wanna play kind of funky, cool stuff. Let notes kind of ring and sing. It does have that kind of singing quality that I think I can attribute to the semi-hollow nature of the guitar. Overall sound, I'm gonna give this one, I'll go ahead and give it an 8.7 on overall sound. And then at a price of $19.49, currently you can click our link for the available colors, availability, all that current pricing. But at $19.49, it is American made as part of the Professional 2 series. Made in Corona, California, includes a hard shell case. I love the just a little bit of value add of having that extra push switch to add that neck pickup, do the Gilmore kind of thing. And you know, a Strat can't do what a Tele can, which is typically, you know, put the two outer pickups together. And with this guitar, you can. And I love that mod. I'm glad that they included that. Overall value under $2,000, American made with the high end features. And what cannot be that easy of a routing job at the factory to have this chambered semi-hollow body, I'm pretty impressed overall with value. I liked playing this guitar a lot. I'm gonna go ahead and give it an 8.9 on overall value. That's gonna bring us to a final score for the Thinline limited edition Stratocaster from Fender of 9.0. I really like it. Let me know what you think of the tone, of the look. I think probably some people will find this to be a deal breaker, but me personally, I think it looks super cool. It's got this kind of funky vibe to it that I really enjoyed. Drop a comment and let me know what you think. Remember, if you're in the market for this or any other guitar, any gear, click to buy that gear using our link. We really do appreciate that. Helps us make these demos. We'll see you on the next demo from Play and Trade Guitars. I'm John. That's Zach behind the camera. And hit subscribe because we are giving away that American-made Martin acoustic guitar. See you guys in the next demo. Take care.